Let's talk about the standard matrix of a linear transformation. So this is, first I want to mention theorem 10 on page 71 of the text. So suppose I have a linear transformation T from Rn to Rm. Then there exists a unique matrix A that has the following property, that T of x is equal to Ax for all x in Rn. In fact, you can say a bit more. You can say exactly what matrix A is. A is the m by n matrix whose jth column is T evaluated at E sub j, right? So Ej, remember, is the vector of all zeros and a 1 in the jth slot. So what that's saying is the matrix A has first column, it's TE1, second column, TE2, and so on until the last column is TEN. For proof, well, just suppose you have a vector x with entries x1 up to xn. You can rewrite that as x1 times e1 plus x2 times e2 all the way up to xn times en. And then we're just going to use linearity of the transformation T. So T of x is T evaluated at x1 e1 plus x2 e2 and so on. But then I can pull out the scalars, and it'll just be x1 times t of e1 plus x2 times t of e2 all the way up to xn times t of en. And now by matrix vector product definition, that's just the matrix with columns te1 up to ten times the vector x. And that's just A times x. Now, we need to verify uniqueness, right? So the theorem is an existence and uniqueness theorem. It says there exists a matrix with some properties and that it's unique. So suppose we have T of x equals Ax and T of x equals Bx for all vectors x. We want to show that the matrix A is equal to the matrix B. And we're going to do that just by checking column by column. Right? If we can show that each column of A is equal to the corresponding column of B, then the matrices are the same. But the jth column of A is just A times the vector Ej, but that's just T evaluated at the vector Ej, which is B times Ej. And so that tells us that the jth column of A is equal to the jth column of B for all J. And therefore, A equals B as desired. Let's take a look at some examples. Suppose T is the linear transformation from R2 to R2. It's given by scaling by a factor of 5. So T of x is 5 times x for all x. Let's compute the standard matrix for T. Well, from the theorem, the standard matrix is this matrix A, whose first column is T of E1, and the second column is T of E2. And so we just have to compute these two vectors. T of E1 is T evaluated at 1, 0, which is 5 times 1, 0, so that's 5, 0. T of E2 is T evaluated at 0, 1, which is 5 times 0, 1, so that's 0, 5. And then you put those as columns of this matrix A. And then that is the standard matrix for this linear transformation. Let's look at a slightly more complicated example. Suppose T is the map from R2 to R2 that's given by reflection about the line y equals x. So I'm going to use the theorem again, and I just need to understand what does T do to the vector E1, and what does it do to the vector E2? So for E1, if I reflect, this is the image of E1 under the map T. So in particular, T of E1 is just the vector 0, 1. E2 is shown here in green, and T of E2 is drawn there. And so T of E2 is 1, 0. And so that tells us that the standard matrix of A is the matrix 0, 1, 1, 0. I just take those, T of E1 is column 1, T of E2 is column 2.